Greetings, everyone. Mike Emmerich here, joined by Eddie Olczyk alongside upstairs and Ray Ferraro near the ice for tonight's terrific matchup. The game between the St. Louis Blues and the Edmonton Oilers. Terrific action lies ahead. Backes is the guy in the faceoff circle for St. Louis. Nugent Hopkins will try to win it from him for the Oilers. We have just begun. With Eddie Olczyk and Ray Ferraro, I'm Mike Emmerich. Puck gathered in behind the net by Fane. Many yards gained to Petrangelo.
Oh, it's very important if he can get that out.
And it's picked up in the defensive zone by Fane.
Oh, paddled aside.
Gets it behind the net. Swept on to Petrangelo.
Oh, a great reaction there as that one was tipped on goal.
Clearly redirected in front of the goaltender. Good stop.
Well, he had to be sharp there. That puck changes directions in front of him, and he's able to follow it to make the stop.
Just over 3 minutes skated here in the first. Nothing on the scoreboard has changed. Still a pair of zeros. The Blues got that. Tremendous scoring chance. Well thrown pass up the middle to Yakupov. And that one's routine. Hangs on to that one, and he'll see a faceoff right near him.
Elliott's made a textbook stop here. He's in good shape positionally. He makes the save, and he makes it look really easy.
The Blues with a clean win on the draw. Muscled long to Berglund. Score!
Berglund's stick was in a ready position to accept that puck and put it in as a one-timer.
Talbot's only able to move so quickly. What a shot.
Is the first goal scored after a lot of work.
Great start. They were ready to play, and it shows on the shot clock as well.
And possession seized in the neutral zone by Fane. And he sends it back into the opposite corner. Rocked to the glass. Possession gained in his own end by Alex Petrangelo. That covers some acreage to Schwartz. He's in on an onside play. Got a piece of it. Slides it to the point. Wonderful save on the redirect.
There's no question. That puck was deflected and a good stop.
Side to side they go, trying to generate something. And that one out of play over the glass. Clock stopped.
Sometimes there's just nowhere to go with the puck. Guys, this is an excellent shot, but the goaltender makes an excellent pad save.
The Blues with a face-off win. To Steen. Angled to Gunnarsson. Looks ahead to start something. Snapped up that right wing to Brouwer. Good distance on that one to Eberle. Shoots one. And that one's just one more save. Puck covered, whistle blown.
Shattenkirk still feeling the effects of that huge hit. He's got to learn you cannot play with your head down at this level.
Just under 8 minutes still to play in this period. The Blues lead 1-0. The Oilers prevail again. Right winged to Tarasenko. Perfect pass in stride. All he had to do was look back, and there it came. geometrically to Purcell. Petrangelo's all defense near that net. The battle for the puck, and he can't get free. Puck corralled behind the net by Alex Petrangelo. Not a long pass, but effective. He's got it. On to Bomeister. Score!
Shot was heavy and dangerous. Good thing it didn't hit anybody.
Talbot's out in position. He's just hoping this hits him. He's not able to move quick enough to make the stop.
The Blues got that faceoff win. Now what? Feathered back in and picked up now in the defensive zone by Everett. Receives that pass right near the net behind. Possession taken by David Backes. Good work through center ice by Puglia. Kicked that one away. Great job on a cut pass.
St. Louis's team play has forced another turnover in this tight game.
Pointed to Klefbom. Held to the glass. Picks it up in his own end. Ahead on that left wing to Backes. Dumped in. Long lead pass to Yakupov. Shoots it on. Not all saves have to be hard. That one wasn't. 20 minutes in the books, and the coaches are paid to do something in the intermissions, too. Let's see if they make a change in this game. Right now, we are done with one. The red light flashed twice, both for the same team. 2-0. Bomeister's marker made this a 2-goal lead for his team. Intermission is next. Underway in period two. Propelled to Bomeister. Return pass to Petrangelo. It's dumped in. Puck collected back behind the net by Fain. Moves it to the shadow of the board. Long lead pass to Eberle. Not a problem there. Locks on that to Brouwer. Takes it on the wing. Back in his defensive end to get it. To Fain. Long pass sprung to Eberle. Let's the shot fly. Turned aside. That covers some acreage to Steen. Held up against the boards. Forcing attention in deep. Great shooting position at the point of drive. Slid to Hall. Up the wing with it now. Nicely received at the point. Oh, a great reaction there as that one was tipped on goal.
An outstanding deflection, but an even better save.
Oh, guys, that looked from my vantage point like it was going to go in. When the puck changed directions, it became a very difficult save for the goalie.
The Blues with a clean win on the draw. Possession on the pickup in the defensive zone by Korpikoski. And he dumps it in. Offensive zone pickup by Letestu. Bad save! He got that one too! Led on to Purcell. With a drive! Nice work with the pass. To Yaskin, sliced through the neutral zone, tries to get it on net, lightning in that glove.
Oh, if you're a shooter, you don't want to see the goaltender flash his glove like that.
On the left wing, great pass. It's a 3-on-2 as they move in. moves it to the barrier at center ice. Score! What a collection of impressive moves on that one.
When you're in that close, there's not a lot of room to be able to put the puck in.
Edzo, he's in good position here, but the shooter's known to be a real accurate shooter. He doesn't have much room, and he doesn't miss it.
The Blues have built a whopping lead. Let's see if they can build on it further, maybe even into double digits before the end of the game. We're only in the second period. And he drops it to the opposite corner. Many yards gained to Pouliot. Moves up along the boards, lets it go. In on goal and easily handled. To Brouwer, diagonally to Steen. Moves up the wing. Right along the blue line to Brouwer. To Sequeira, angled to Eberle. Charged up the wing by Eberle. Take it to the slot, wonderful work in close and a brilliant save.
The goalie makes himself look big.
Just a bit over 4 minutes remaining in the period. Do you see a pattern developing here? They're up now by three. Splendid pass through center to Tarasenko. Good deep, wonderful save. It didn't look like he had a thing to shoot at. He got his pad on it. Takes it up that side. They score! They only trail by a pair.
Hall's reading of the play, he knew the puck was below the goal line. He got it and he one-timed it in.
It looks to me sometimes as the goaltender's guessing a bit, and when he guesses, he drops into the default butterfly position to see if he can cover enough net.
Edmonton's found themselves back in this game. They trail only by two, and we're still in the second period, though late. The Blues prevail on the draw. Right up the side. This one goes diagonally into the zone. Swept on to Eberle. Carried toward the woodwork by Eberle. And that is the end of the second period of this game. One more to go, and who knows, maybe more action beyond that. You decide what these shot totals tell you. 16 for Edmonton and 10 for the Blues. That's where we stand now as we head to break. Two teams have played hard through two, and we begin period three. Got a piece of that one. It's a 3-on-2. How will they defend this? Shoots. Wonderful save on the redirect.
Those are some of the tougher saves for goaltenders, the deflections in front.
Should be way easier to get out of your zone than this. A defensive zone turnover forces the goaltender into a difficult spot.
And they get it. Good strength on the tie-up. To Yakupov. To Hall. Gets in. What'll he do? Got it at the point. Tarasenko's cutting through the neutral zone. And this play is whistled down. It is offside. A little over 4 minutes off the clock. A two-goal spread in this one, 3-1. Neutralized face-off win. Taken away.
The Blues have forced another turnover, Doc. They've done a real nice job in that category in this close game.
A shot, and that one's routine. Possession now on the puck in his own end by Pouliot. Good distance on that one to Eberle. Right near the line to Eberle. Let's it go. And the puck is taken in the defensive zone by David Backes. Right from the slot. Missed again.
Another quality chance for him. That's a night he wants to forget.
At the point. Big shot. And possession once again in his own end by Brouwer. Geometrically to Backes. Right near the goal stripe to Schwartz. Took it up the boards and holds. Muscled long to Gunnarsson. He scores! Second of the game. What a performance.
Schwartz knew he was in a prime scoring area, so he went to the wrist shot and scored.
Talbot's not going to be able to do much about that beautiful shot, but he's got to have some help in front of him. That was a poor read by his defensive player.
The Oilers control from the neutral zone. Up the left side to Korpakovsky. Laid on. Score! They're back to within two now.
Purcell's quick release allowed him to score from the high slot.
I don't know how he could be in much better position, Eddie. I got a clean look at this. That is a perfectly placed shot.
The Oilers have closed the gap to just two, and there is time here in the third period to get another one or maybe get two and get this game back even. Gathered in by Bomeister. Long lead pass to Berglund. Good attempt, but a weak stick. Carries it toward the woodwork. Directed on. Score! Two in a row.
Korpakovsky's able to get himself in position to one-time that puck to the back of the net.
The passer recognizes that he's got to get the puck up in the air, but he displays sweet hands as it goes just over the stick and lands flat on the ice.
Edmonton's deficit is only one because of that last goal. Let's see if they can tie it up here in the third. The Blues from the neutral zone start to work. Now it's in the opposite corner. Right near the line, can he keep it going? Long lead pass to Gunnarsson. Takes that pass up the boards. Oh, a save there. Moved up the side by Eberle. And that's an offside.
Well, from my eye line, I think this is in, guys, but it's an unbelievable stop. It keeps his team in shouting distance of the lead.
A good tie-up on the faceoff. That led to his team getting the puck. And it's turned right back to Sequeira. Worked again to Fane. Cuts between the blue lines, and that's moved up the boards to Pouliot. Wow, what a glove save!
Oh, that puck just hit his glove.
To Petrangelo. Up the wing. Lets it go. Nicely patted away. Puck covered, whistle blown. win it. Oh, he got that. Looks ahead to start something. Possession taken over by Puglia. Takes that cross-ice pass from his left and is able to march on. Got a piece of it. Picks it up in his own end. Good look and a solid pass up the boards to Tarasenko. Can he generate something? Chip de la Terra. A hammer shot from the point. Outstanding save. Score! That puts his team up by a pair. Tarasenko's first shot was stopped, and he followed up with the second one and put it in.
Talbot's decided to stay up on his feet here. That opens up lots of room low on the stick side.
A face-off win. Let's see what develops. On to Bomeister. To Pietrangelo.
Pietrangelo's creating chances for his teammates with two assists so far.
Back in his defensive end to get it. Led on to Eberle. With a shot. Guided the goal again. Looks ahead to start something. Game over. It was a victory on the scoreboard that was decisive. And it wasn't just there.
The center iceman ruled the faceoff circle. And when you do that, you're going to have great success on the scoreboard.
We thank you for watching. We hope you enjoyed the evening as much as we did. For Eddie Olczyk and Ray Ferraro, Mike Emmerich saying good night.